person talk of jargon.
Yeah.
When person they say, ah, this way they talk now jargon. What do you understand or what if you say the definition
make
of that
I first talk and say jargon no mean nonsense. Because now that people think every time when they hear jargon, now waiting that they think that say now say I talk nonsense. No. Jargon just simply means a lexicon of a particular or the language, let's say, of a particular field or profession. Some words where they speak for that profession, where they peculiar to that profession, where we say whether not only them go understand or people we don't learn about and go understand the meaning of that word or that phrase or that sentence. Now it be jargon.
So that be the actual
jargon. So every profession gets its own jargon. Accountants get their jargon, engineers get their jargon, architects get their jargon.
All those pari passu.
You know, exactly, you know. So now, so law too gets its own jargon.
All right, you don't hear that more. So in case the person tell you say you are speaking jargons, it just means say you speak some kind phrases or some kind of words. Maybe like say it is peculiar to you or your profession. Maybe like say that person no understand. Not be insult. So today we want to talk about legal jargons. All those legal phrases, all those legal words, and what did they mean? Because some people don't learn for inside wahala because they don't understand them.
Yes, you.
Some people just click yes. They go speak click yes. Yeah, you have click yes. You go look. They go give you form. You go look. Okay. Terms and conditions. Okay, sign. You don't sign. Put. And when you sign and when they stamp, it is finished. It is legally binding. Bye. Now, why Mr. Tommy don't they here to explain all those words? Where be like say they look like a play. But it actually means something. Mr. Tommy, over to you.
I agree with what they both talk about because you see, jargon no be say nonsense. As you don't talk about well. It means now the peculiar language where that kind of feed. Brickley they get their own jargon.
Yes, sir.
Carpenter get their own jargon. Nobody, even mechanic get their own jargon. We be saying even for marketplace, they get market jargon. We be say nobody say they spoke nonsense. Now the language where they peculiar. We be say those people they for that internet trade, they all get jargon. Everybody get their jargon. But legal jargon be say the one where lawyer they talk, we be say it they affect many people because nothing where you do will not affect law. Will not no affect.
Yes.
So that's why many people don't understand the thing we call jargon for law. And that one they hurt people pass because now until you go tell a place now you go no say get tell or get jargon. But many people, you know, they get one, they rob your body, your business, your career, they rob off with law one way or the other. And you know every day. Now every day they enter to me and say terms and conditions apply. Every day.
Wait till you know when we say terms and
conditions. Wait till you understand by terms and conditions. Ezioku.
So some places have
and it's for online it's for everywhere.
C and C apply.
Yes.
What it be C and C?
Condition.
Terms and
T and C. Okay, T and C. Okay, then I C
and C. They go tell you.
T and C.
It apply.
You really cannot. Is it that you want to sign that thing or you don't want to sign?
It's not by force.
There is no forcing you on, and there is no negotiation again. That's you can't right. Say, can you change this number 6? I don't like it. Change it to this one. No. Is that you take it or no? And I think that is the reason why a lot of people just sign it. Because they feel that, look, whatever I'm not in support of, I really can't change it.
Okay.
Exactly.
You download one application now, whatever. They will say, you should agree, click agree or you don't agree. If you don't agree, you are not going to use the application now.
See, you are not
and you want to use the application and you know a lot of people want to use it or have been using it. So you click agree. Can we really say that kind of a thing can really be binding and cannot be
It can be. It's binding. It's binding because you see, you have the freedom of choice. The freedom to say, I will not do it. Some people don't do it.
Okay. So apart from that particular terms and condition, which other legal jargon maybe like say?
So many.
Let me just touch on as many as possible.
And they for Latin. Why, sir?
Because you see, now.
Why you say a number of those jargons they are in Latin?
Now because maybe for sake of style or sometimes sake of say you want you
classy. You want the classy, effizy.
Like caveat emptor. You know, let bias beware.
That's all that it means. So caveat emptor means bias beware.
Just beware. And you see, that caveat emptor, we see that ordinarily, you know, you are supposed to check what you want to buy. It's not just about property. So like if I go to store ordinarily, if I go to a store and I want to buy a tea mug and I did not check it well, if I get back home, I pour tea inside the tea, enter the cup and it's leaking, then I don't have ordinarily a right to go back and ask for another refund because it is let buyers beware. But in some climes, in some society, they will, because of that rule, they will put provisions in place, legal provisions in place that look, consumers have the right to reject what they have bought that is not applicable to what they want to use it for.
Okay.
You know, that's what you see, maybe in UK. Mm. I mean, after 14 days, I mean, between 14 days, you can still return your shirt after you have bought it, return back to say, I don't like it again. And they have what is called no question asked. They'll just give you back your money or ask you to go and make an exchange, as it were. But in some climes, just you have to, particularly in property, when you are buying property,
it's
caveat emptor. It's your duty as a buyer to ensure that you check everything. So it's not the duty of your agent. It's not the duty of whoever is luring you to buy that property. It is
now your full responsibility.
Full responsibility. Nothing missing.
However, if you recruit an agent,
yes,
he also has a duty to you,
yeah,
which you can probe him for. I know.
Yes, but that's between you and him.
Yes, that's between you and him. Not between you and him and the buyer.
No, no, it's between
if he ended up convincing you to buy something that you now discovered is wrong,
it's wrong.
Not often
you cannot. Yes, you cannot go to the buyer
or the seller.
You are the seller.
And say that
you have to resort to your agent that you engaged for a particular service and didn't deliver that duty to you.
Yeah, all right. Aside from a caveat and tall, aka buyers beware, which other
cars are parked at owner's risk.
Cars are parked at owner's risk.
It's a legal term many don't understand.
Meaning
the fact that you see, I you have come to come and do business with me, or you have come to come and worship in our place of worship, or you have come to do something with me, because you have come to me, I kind of owe you a sense of duty to ensure that while you are within my premises, that I safeguard your property. I owe you, you know, that sense of duty.
Naturally.
Nice. You call it a duty of care. Yeah. You know, so if there is that a breach of that duty of care, is it, they call it in thought, in law. They said that they have breached a thought. I mean, it's a tortious act. You have neglected to be responsible to me. So now, I'm the one that packed you. That even adds more to it, that I packed you. I put you there. So I'm, in a way, giving you an assurance that your car will be safe. But I want to put it clear that, yes, I put it there, but I don't want to owe you responsibility for that safety of that car.
Okay.
So I am putting a notice of exclusion. A notice.
Anything
that,
we do your car.
Yes, that look, even though I say drive, put an auto, aha, basa, you don't do. I put you there, but I am not going to accept responsibility for your car. In fact, some people will say, cars and content are parked at owner's risk. So it's not even
just cars.
It's not even when the car is moved. When you come back and somebody has opened your car, taken your purse out, or done something there, don't hold me responsible. Even though I have my guards outside, don't hold me responsible because I have told you that I have excluded my liability. That's what it's called. Exclusion of liability, because even times when you go to what is called dry cleaners, they will tell you that you see what you have brought to us, we can only pay you 5% of whatever we charge you. You both gave them a sick dress of about 1 million or 100,000, whatever, and they burnt it, and they said that we are only going to pay you probably just 10% of what you paid us as cost of doing that thing. And you said that, how dare you? I brought it. Say, look, it's a contract.
Exactly.
It's not a police case. It's a contract. I wanted to offer you service. And then when you are about to sign, I gave a document to sign. If you didn't read it, it's your own business.
Yeah.
But at the back of it or in front of it, I put there, you know, read the terms and conditions. And if you are too fast, you are too in a hurry to, because they've told you I'm a very good cleaner. You have trusted me so many times, I've never disappointed you. I've disappointed you. And it's not even, I would not like to disappoint you. But occasionally, I know I'm about your dress. Yeah. Occasionally, I might have given your dress to somebody else. And by the time you came back, you probably want to wear it that same evening. But mistakenly, logistics wise, I gave your cloth to Mr. Vincent in First Tack, whereas your own Vincent is in Lekki. It was a mistake. So, but I will try to sack for you. You cannot sue me beyond what you have agreed for. That is what is called ESMA.
Contract, letter of employment. What if all those easy words, legal words, some people they, when people know they see.
You see the
when they know they see, but they fall into that trap.
Contract, I mean employment na contract. Anytime, and you see contract na legal term. Let me say, there's an agreement between two people which the law court will enforce. There is offer, acceptance, capacity, consideration, all those things are there. Legality. So anything we are doing with somebody, employer or employee, now terms and conditions. That's why it's very important that when you are entering that contract, you ask, what are the terms and conditions? If they don't give you that terms and conditions, that means all of you are going to float and anything goes. But most times when they give you terms and conditions, say, okay, read. Many people know they read them. You see, when you give the, particularly when you say they give some organization, their terms and conditions are not for that letter. They will just say they refer you to the terms and conditions of the organization. They will just give you a summary of what the emoluments be, how much, you know, and what have you. Okay, this is where you are supposed to get. This your contract is starting this day. But we refer you to the terms and conditions of the organization. Which many people, when they get that letter and that testimony, they don't remember to go see that terms and conditions.
Go read them.
Maybe say, you know, you don't work for 4 days or maybe five months and 29 days. They can't say they sack you. That means you don't get terms, you don't get anything. Now dismissal.
Okay.
And things like that. So it's very important that you engage in reading the terms and conditions.
Better life.
I qualify.
Yes, so what's the name?
Magidi.
Good afternoon. What's the name and where are you calling us from?
I'm calling you from Songo.
Songo.
My name is Uchenna.
Uchenna, how you doing?
Fine, mother. I've been listening to the program right from the time we started.
All right.
The last word is discussed concerning land issues.
Yes.
I'm very interested because I'm a victim of it.
Right
now.
Wow, share your experience.
Okay, sir. I have a family property.
Okay.
In my town.
Okay.
The family is being made of three people. My father.
Okay.
My father and my father elder brother and the younger brother.
Okay.
And the both of the three of them is late.
They're late. Okay, they're dead.
Yeah, born together. So
okay.
That boy is the last born and is the son of the last brother. Of the family. Yeah.
Yeah.
Now he went without on our note on the family. My own personal house is there in that family. My father's house is there, and it's just like the boy doesn't have a house there, but his own father's house is there. He went and sold the compound, part of the compound that all, every one of us has building. He sold it to one of our town person in the village on our notice, and we see a building going on. And they called me. They wanted my uncle them land to fight over that. This boy said he's the one that is building. Issue went to raise. I stopped my elder brother, not intervene, that if our younger brother get money to build out, let us allow him to build. But if he's not the one building it, if we have been caught, any day I hear that another person came from another place building there, that I will do everything possible within my capacity to erase that person from there to take over the property. So as I speak to you now, after like 2 years, the building, 4-bedroom flat, they don't roof and finish, put window, put door.
Wow.
Now, somebody come up and went to our eBay and they give them some percentage that he's the one building that property, and they bought it. He bought it from that our brother.
Wow.
And then when this issue happened, we reported the matter to eBay.
Okay.
And the whole village at the same time. And we also told the man, if you are the one doing this, some people said you are the one doing it. are you the one doing it? He said, no. If you are the one doing it, remove your hand. And the matter, he said, no, not him. The matter didn't end there. We gathered the whole village and the ladies complained. If he's the one, he should remove his hand. He said, no, he's not the one. Okay. Later, after 2 years, the lady says he's the one. Now, as I'm talking to you now,
okay.
The place is under lockdown. I've affected the man never to enter there for his
okay.
life. Mm-hmm. But the matter now, why I want to let you know now, why I'm asking, I don't want to go to court by myself because of, but I've told him that he can take me to court by himself. I will answer him. So I don't know if I'm fighting the right fight.
Okay. You are fighting the right fight.
All right. Thank you so much. Mary. Thank you. Okay.
The right fight.
Is he fighting the right fight?
Yes, it's a family
problem. So if he go court.
Let the other man go to court. Every man go to court.
As he go not resolve
him. Let him go to court because if it's a family property,
yeah.
Things like that. So one individual cannot lay claim to what belongs to a family.
Just to declare, we not say we get some landed properties in the village where we don't get documents.
Mm-hmm.
In a case like that, make I just ask, in case you get land where the village where you don't get documents, Papa just show you say, this is your land. From here to yes, your land. From here to yes, your land. How person fits actually lay claim to that
by historical analysis, yes. By historical deductions, by
anybody feel wrong.
What yes. people need to understand
customer see, right of occupancy.
Exactly.
So basically, just go local government, go get documents for
no,
that.
No. You see, what you want to do that, you want to say you want to go to local government to get that too. Then you have to also prove that you are entitled to that land.
To that land. You see, title is not just by some form of documentation, title is as a result of some action. You understand? Or some rights
okay.
that you now have.
I like that word.
Do you understand? Some rights that you now have as a result of probably certain actions or okay. certain things where you... So if they burn you for one family, we be say they get customary ownership of a land, you don't be part of the owner as a result of your birth.
Yeah, so any more thing we need to know about legal jargons, Ogatomi?
Yes, plenty. You know, many people, for instance, hear MOU, Memorandum of Understanding, and contract.
Now that one, I our resident doctor to the fight government.
You see, Memorandum of Understanding na legal jargon. It means say two of us still they negotiate. Now get some understanding when I don't pen down, but you don't have legal binding effect.
Whoa. MOU. Yeah, no, I just wanted people to get that emphasis.
I better talk again.
MOU cannot be legally enforced. Mm. That's what he's saying.
Mm.
It's just some understanding
that you have not penned down.
That you have put down. It's not really a contract yet.
It's not an agreement.
It's not an agreement yet.
It's like the understanding you have.
Mm.
But some people they smile because okay, this part of this understanding, if it involves say with you. You go spend money, you go do whatever. That aspect can become contractual. You go repay me back my money and things like that.
Mm.
But in the main, MOU, different from contract.
Mm.
Contract, na say, na don't enter enforceable agreement.
Mm.
MOU, na say, na don't pen down the understanding you na get.
Mm.
Okay. Mm. All right. Any other thing that people need to know?
Plenty. Acknowledgement receipt, different from official receipt. Acknowledgement receipt. Say you give me money now, I can say I acknowledge the money from you. So I can say, okay, take this paper to notify you, say I acknowledge, say I collect the money. But it's different for official receipts, maybe say go there indicative of the thing where you pay for.
Okay.
Are you understanding me?
Okay.
Acknowledge me, say, okay, like somebody come my office now, say, okay, anybody will bring money come my office, so take money from them. Received from Mr. Debo the sum of 500,000 naira. That's acknowledgement.
No, let me give you 5 million. Make it 5 million. Receive from Mr. Debo 5 million.
I beg you, put down 500 more. Receive from Mr. Debo 500.
Hey! 5.5. Now that one, I've been up with 5 million. You cannot belittle a circular law. 500,000 for what?
Can you imagine? Just exactly what are you.
Where are you driving at?
I mean, just exactly what are you high on now?
Can you imagine? This is
defamation. 5.5. So what they are saying is, if somebody says, I hereby acknowledge that I received the sum of 5.5 million naira from Mr. Debo Adejan.
Is different from official receipt for whatever you paid for.
So can an official receipt also then just mean I hereby acknowledge that I receive 5,500,000 from Mr. Deba
payment
for so.
Yes.
Is that what makes it different?
Official. Yes.
I just want to be so that people will be clear that it's not about that you have a typed receipt or a designed receipt. That
because I can that's why I have to be very careful about narrative when you're sending money. If I send 50,000 to you, their money, but I not put a narrative of what it is for
purpose,
then that is just that there is an acknowledgement of money
but not for anything.
Not an official receipt.
It could be for anything.
Yes, for anything.